We're into another week again where it's very similar weather to last week. That is, we'll see during the week that it'll be high to very high fire danger and will heat up Friday into Saturday. So interesting enough, that's the trend we've seen now. But it's interesting now that we're seeing humid weather, which is keeping the fire danger ratings down. We're seeing warmish to hot days that have little wind. So we're not seeing the fire danger ratings elevate even when the temperatures are in the high 30s and even in the low 40s. The wind's just not there, and the fact that it's humid. So that's the scenario we've got. But it's interesting to look back that we've had extreme heat, and there's been heat alerts issued by the health department over the weekend. It's been very uncomfortable, I think, for most people, even sleeping during the nights, because it's been overnight temperatures are up. So that humid time, that warmer time, is certainly challenging a few people, but it's certainly not bringing on severe fire weather. However, we have had some small fires that have been dealt with effectively. I think the most important thing this week is to stay focused on the weekend. At this stage, it'll be a warm Friday, Saturday. That's the focal point for us. And apart from that, there will be some burning done by DELP. So the planned burning program will kick off, only in very small areas, but stay attuned to that, and that information's available on the DELP website about all their planned burns. And obviously, planned burns will also come up on the Emergency Vic website when they're there, that you can get that information. So I think that's important to stay attuned to your local conditions about what DELP and CFA are doing in planned burning. Thank you, and we'll obviously continue this next week to give you the overview of what is March and what is seen to be a longer, drier period in March. But we're certainly seeing that we haven't got elevated fire dangers this week.